Another characteristic of a queuing system is the number of servers. There can be a single server or multiple servers. In a single server system, as soon as a server becomes free, one customer among those waiting uses it, assuming that the waiting buffer is not empty. In this example, when the blue customer leaves the system, the first customer in the waiting buffer, the red one, starts to be served. In a system with multiple servers, there are several servers which can handle customers simultaneously. In that case, there cannot be any customers in the waiting buffer unless all the servers are busy. If there are customers in the waiting buffer, one of them starts being served as soon as one of the servers is released. In general, it is assumed that the servers are identical and the different service durations are therefore statistically indistinguishable. They follow the same probability law. To end, one has to define the maximum number of customers in the system. This includes the servers and the number of positions in the waiting buffer. In this example, the maximum number of customers is 7, since there can be one client being served and up to 6 clients waiting. We differentiate between queues with a finite buffer and queues with an infinite buffer. If the buffer is finite, then some customers may be blocked, since they may arrive when the buffer is full. These queues are called blocking systems. On the contrary, in queuing systems with an infinite buffer, customers are never blocked. If a new customer arrives and the servers are busy, then the customer lines up in the waiting buffer and waits to be served. These queues are pure waiting systems.